WordPress Content Crawler is a plugin that can bring content from almost any site to your WordPress blog. It uses CSS selectors to achieve this. A CSS selector helps you find an element in HTML of a web page using attributes of the element, such as class and ID. Let's look at a few examples. Here is a hyperlink element with next page class. If we want to select this element using CSS selectors, we can write this. Here is another example. This is a div element with an ID of content. To select this element, we can do this. We can also use outer elements attributes to find the right element we want to select. For instance, if there is a div element with a class name of pagination, and there is a hyperlink inside it, we can write a CSS selector like this. Now you know how to use CSS selectors. To be able to find the elements we want in a web page, we need to see the source code of the page. To do this, first, we need to browse the page. Then, we need to open Developer Tools in the browser. When the Developer Tools window is opened, you can see the source code of the page in Elements tab. Now that we are able to see all of the elements and their attributes, we can write CSS selectors. Let's begin configuring settings for a site. First, create a new site, give it a name, and fill in main site URL. Now let's start configuring category settings. Here, we need to provide links to the categories, which include posts. You can either add all categories manually, or use CSS selectors to automatically get category links. Let's use a CSS selector. Go to the page which has category links, open Developer Tools and find the links in the source code. Then, look at the attributes of the link containers. As you can see, the category links are inside the list elements in nav element. So, let's write a CSS selector for hyperlinks and lists, which are inside a nav element with nav class. First, fill the test category page link, and then write the CSS selector. Next, press the plus button. All of the category links are taken and inserted. Remove unwanted links and select a category from your site for each category link. This way, when posts are taken from the site, they will be inserted in the category you want. Now, let's go to a category and find the CSS selector for the post links. Use developer tools to find the elements which include links for the posts. As you can see, each post is in an article element with the post class. Inside this element, there is an h2 tag which contains the link for the post. Let's write a CSS selector for this and test it. Great, it works. You can remove unnecessary elements from the source code, such as scripts. Now, let's find CSS selectors for featured images of the posts, so that they are saved as featured images for the post in our site. Do the same procedure and find the featured images. Check if the images come before the post links in the source code. In this example, they don't. Finally, find the CSS selector for the next page link. In this example, next pages are loaded when you reach the end of the page. However, there is a link which we are not able to see in the page, and we can find it in the source code. Let's find it and write its CSS selector. Oops. There is a duplicate category link. Remove it and save the settings. We are done configuring category page. Let's go to the tester and check a category page to see if it works properly. We can see featured images and post links, as well as next page link. Let's check the next page as well. It looks like everything works properly. Now, let's go and configure post page. Go to a post, copy its link and paste it as the test post link. Using developer tools, find a CSS selector for the post title. It seems that the post titles are in H1 element, which has post title class. Now, let's get the content of the post. There is a div element with entry class, and again, a div element with post content class inside of which. Let's remove scripts, since they can cause unwanted behaviors. Let's save meta keywords and meta description. Also, we can save the images to our site server. You can just write img to save all of the images in the content of the post. We can also save a featured image from the post page if there is no featured image found in category page for this post. Let's write a CSS selector for featured images. If more than one image is found, don't worry. First found image will be used as featured image. Finally, let's prepare the template for the post. You can use the buttons above the editor. When you hover over them, explanations will be shown. Let's put main content here, and add a source link to direct user the source site. Now, let's check if it works as expected. Great, everything works as we want. You can see that the images are saved to our server. You can use tools to manually save a post by providing its link. Now, we have the post created in our site. Awesome! Let's go to General Settings page and activate scheduling. By this way, the posts are automatically saved, and each category will be checked for new posts. Finally, let's activate the site we have just created, meaning that it is suitable for automated crawling. Thanks for watching.